Alright, hey everybody, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be doing VR on the, what are we going to do? We're going to do Lightroom. So I'm Isaias, also known as Ijyoyo, and we've already done a Premiere video, and that actually took a little bit. But I was on here the other day with the Lightroom, and it worked out really well. So that's what we're going to do. So... okay, so I chose four different pictures. Let me see if I can. No. Usually. So I have my laptop right here, too. Okay. All right, so we're in Lightroom now. So I chose four different pictures, three portraits, and then a landscape photo. So let's go start with the portrait. And I just want to see how comfortable this is. Okay. Let's see. So we got this image. So far, so good. I think the colors actually are really amazing. Like it's, I don't know, it's a lot easier looking at it in Lightroom because everything's so close. And you can zoom in too. So I know this image, for example, was pretty, it's pretty dark in here. We can look at the, see if we can toggle this. Control-I. I don't know if that's gonna actually toggle it. Okay. Anyways, yeah, so and this was back on the Canon 70D. So let me go into tone curve here, and it does have some issues trying to get the right button. And I also noticed this as well last time is that it doesn't like the tone curve. It really does not like the tone curve. Which really is too bad. So we're going to go into color grading. And we're going to... oh, it doesn't even like that anymore. Okay. Oh. I don't know what happened. Okay. Guess we're not doing that. So... let's go into detail, and we're going to bring up the noise reduction to try and clear some of that color up. We're not going to do anything too fancy here. Let me get in here. I don't know why it's left-clicking only. That's odd. No, that's not what I wanted. I do. It's actually comfortable because now I can set my hands down without having to like have them steady the whole time. Let's go into color calibrations. Fine. What am I? Okay. I think it's really dark in some of these areas, so I'm gonna press Alt, and hopefully, can I reset this? For photo editing, that it doesn't really require. This looks really big to my eyes. It's like right in front of me. It's like all over the place. So let's go into, okay, let's go to the next one. So we're going to go with this and next one. Hopefully that works. Okay. Zoom out. Or can we go from this way? Okay, yeah, there we go. So this is the next one. Now, I think the colors are actually incredibly different because on my computer screen, it's saying it's more of an orange color, a lot more orange. So that is very different than what I'm seeing on the screen, on this screen. What I'm going to do is I'm going to change the environment to, let's go back black void. Let's bring it closer to me. And height, that's good. Curvature, I think curves are all the way up already. And size, let's make this bigger. Let's make it huge, okay. Okay, let's go back in here. Okay, let's brighten that up. Now that I know that the color is completely off, it's kind of annoying because now I don't know what that true color is. I can obviously look at my computer here and check, but and like I said, I'm not gonna do anything too crazy. But this is really nice. I think this for Lightroom works really well compared to something like Premiere, where you have to have, well, you don't have to have, but I am familiar with using multiple modules at a time, or having them up at least so that I can easily get to them. Okay, so that, see on my computer, that's desaturated, and you can tell that it's desaturated. This one, it doesn't look too desaturated. I'm gonna change that to 0. And I kind of need to, I can also like move it, which is kind of cool. I believe you can lock it, dude, that's cool. Yeah, you can bring it upside down if you really want to. Let me get in. Wow, that's cool. Okay, you can like, I don't know if it's gonna turn. That's really cool, I think. Actually, no. You can't do anything like that in Premiere. Okay. Yeah, you can, like, fine-tune. That's really, wow. Like, that's too close, but, like, that's kind of cool. Yeah, this is basically me playing around. Not an actual... I think there's a lot of, I don't know if that's real or not, the fringing, it looks like the fringing isn't actually a thing in the actual photo. So what I'm going to do, okay, I'm just going to head on to the next one, but that's just something I noticed, that the color's a little bit different. So we're going to go to the next one. Next one is... the color is also different here. And I think you can change this in the headset, but it should already be all the way up to the blues, which is very odd. So I don't really like this composition at all, so we're going to change the crop real quick. And I love the histrium up there. Got a video on the histrium if you guys wanted to go check that out. Let's go original. And bring this down. I want to get his watch in there, even though it's kind of blurred out. Yeah, so the color on here is very different from what my Mac chose. Maybe my Mac is incorrect. Because this is significantly off. I also want to mention a couple people. Thank you, CJ, for commenting on my last video. And also, yeah, CJ's been around for quite a while. Pretty awesome dude. And Rocky as well for commenting on my last video. I know I dumped all my books for coming out to the videos once again. Yes, I am making videos. If you guys want to see anything or want to see any, there's more hotkeys involved than that. So, but this was a very pleasurable experience, and I'm not getting very dizzy at all because I'm not, well, I'm not sure. I guess I'm not sitting up. I think that was the problem last time. But, yeah, if you guys want to see more, don't forget to subscribe and check out the other playlist. And I will talk to you guys later.